Welcome back to another episode of The Fit Show, powered by bodybuilding.com. This is Milos Sarcev, pro bodybuilder. I'm here in Colosseum Gym Fullerton, Mecca of bodybuilding here in Orange County. Today's segment is training shoulders or deltoids. As important muscle group for all competitive bodybuilders and men in general, I'm gonna show you what I learned in 20 years of my training experience, how to develop front, side, and rear portion of a deltoid. Very important aspect for building complete package, what we need today on the stage for competitive IBB pros or NPC competitors. So let's go and do it. Before we start with the shoulder training routine, I would like to answer some questions that I receive constantly on my website and on thefitshow.com. How many sets, how many reps, how many different exercises per body part? That's the question. It's really depending on your specific goals. But to summarize, I'm gonna say, if you're a strength athlete and you want the power, you should train in 1 to 5 repetition per set protocol. If you're a bodybuilder and your primary concern is to build muscle size, you should train between 6 and 12 repetition per set. That stimulates fast twitch muscle fiber responsible for growth. And finally, if you do wanna just be in shape and muscle tone, definition, endurance is your primary concern, you should do high repetition per each set, over 15, and I even do over 100 repetitions per set. So don't limit yourself at that. I just like to quote my childhood hero, Bruce Lee, who was observing everyone and everything, accepting what was useful, discarding what was useless, and creating what was essentially his own. What we want to do here at The Fit Show is to get you some options that you can apply to design a perfect training routine for you, for your specific goals. So let's go do shoulders. It's a big body part. We have a lot to do. It's a front, side, and rear deltoid we need to explain. So let's go and build that Olympia-sized deltoids. Okay, I want to introduce you again to my training partner, Marcelo Caravello, in training for Nationals 2005. He's going to be here demonstrating some of the exercises for today's shoulder training routine. First and foremost, I would like to start with the overhead presses, bread and butter of any shoulder training routine. And it's going to be variations of military press, standing, seated, in front, behind the neck, dumbbells. So let's go to work. Marcelo is going to show you first standard military press, standing, which is going to be a power move that he's going to do it in standing position, in front, just like he's doing right now, which stimulates front deltoid, one of the three heads of a deltoid muscle. Let's now try it behind the neck. This is variation. When he's standing position, he is doing behind, which for granted is not physiologically safe. It's a little bit hard on the shoulder joint, but a lot of guys can do it safely, just like he's doing it controlled, slow and controlled. Okay, let me get this. Now the same thing we can do in a seated position. And you can start from behind the neck first. Military press behind the neck in a seated position. And a few more in front. As you can see, he is doing it very slow, controlling all the way down, full range of motion, and contracting his front deltoid on the top. This is barbell military press. Now he's going to do dumbbells in seated position first, and he's going to show you a couple of different moves as well. I like to do this, go ahead, straight. He can do it in a slower fashion, which is my favorite, as you know so far, go much slower, and slow and controlled down. Slowly up, you know, do several reps. In the previous two segments of Fit Show, I introduced you to this super slow method, and some people do believe that this is really gonna put you to sleep and it's not worth. This is very hard to do and isolates the muscle completely. Go ahead. And when it gets heavy, you just drop it and do descending sets with a lower weight. One of the most intense training method is descending sets. So you do 6, 8, 10 repetitions with initial weight, and then you go with the, drop the weight and do with the lighter. Okay, go ahead. Again, go super slow. Now, here is just like what I was doing for legs. I would like to challenge a few people to do this exercise in exact manner that he is doing it right now. Super slow, and not just slow on the way down, which is common, but slow on the way up. The same principle of contracting the muscle rather than pushing. Okay, go ahead. And I'll do the standing few more.
Standing?
Standing. Okay. And 155 more. Okay, you can jump down. So as you can see, even the small little weight of 20 pounds exhausted Marcel, that he was not able to complete 3-4 repetitions with this small weight. And I trained with Marcella, and I can tell you he's actually stronger than me in most of the shoulder moves. So to summarize, overhead press does this front deltoid. Turn around. So lift your arm. Okay, here it is, front deltoid. This is the portion that is highly visible from the front, from the side, and from the back. And any overhead press is going to be stimulating mostly this portion of the delt. So, thank you. For front deltoid, any overhead press, absolutely anything that you push the weight above your head would stimulate the front delt. There was a few people that contacted fitshow.com stating that any particular exercise is not better for portion of the muscle, stating that if you do the exercise, it's going to equally stimulate each muscle fiber of that particular muscle. That's really not so. If that's the case, we would have one exercise per body part, and we would not need to do any variations of. So for a front deltoid, even variations that I just showed you here, with the dumbbells, with the barbell, behind the neck, in front, would do a little tricks, and it would stimulate different fibers. So please, next time you train delts, try maybe one of each, and collect the experience and see what works for you the best. So front delt, any overhead press, absolutely. Let's move on to another exercises for deltoids. Next exercise for front deltoid is going to be front shoulder raises. I'm going to do variations of those as well. It's a front dumbbell, cable, or barbell raise. And Marcel is going to demonstrate again. He has a very developed front deltoid, and this is the portion that we are talking about, which is going to be used in a front raise barbell and dumbbell move. As you can see, this is the muscle that contracts. So let's demonstrate this with the barbell first. And again, it's not the Bible, it's a barbell. He's doing it perfectly. Slow control down and straight up. This is isolating move. It's quite hard to do. And not too many people do this, contrary to overhead presses that everybody does. But I would suggest you to try those. It's isolating move for a front deltoid and a very good shaping exercise. Slow down, controlled, and up, crossing the eye level. Okay, perfect. Now drop it down and let's do it with the dumbbells. Same exercise can be done with the dumbbells. And it's done like this. Go straight up. Okay. And I like to do a little bit wider version to the side of the body. And then all the way in. As deltoid work, not just by raising the arm, it's also bringing the inwards right here. Okay. Now, a few more. And do it in a seated position. Every time we do something seated, excludes the momentum that we can use, using a standing position. Go ahead. So, now I would like to warn you, this is very hard exercise to do, so don't try to use a super heavy weight because you're not going to be able to do it in a perfect form. Okay, down and slow down. In seated position, he doesn't have a choice. He has to use really his front delt. Okay, one more. That's good. You're down. And let's move on to the cable. After standing, seated position, barbell and dumbbell, we can do the same exercise using the cable. Go ahead. And it's good finishing move. I usually like to do this close to the contest. And as you can see, again, it stimulates the exact part front deltoid that we want to reach. All the way, control down. As I said before, cables have a different aspect. It's not just a gravity that you're fighting the gravity. You have to go as far on a low pulley how much this weight is pulling you back. So you can stretch more, and range of motion is much greater on the cable exercises. Okay, that's it. So come here. While everybody does overhead presses, and it's a really bread and butter of a shoulder training routine. I know that a little trick that everybody always starts shoulder routine with the front deltoids. I would say that's a little mistake, because if you have undeveloped part of the delt, which in most cases would be a rear delt, I would suggest them to prioritize that and do rear delt first in the training routine, and then put side and front delt, you know, somewhere else. It's not a rule that we have to go by, that front delts are first and then side and then rear. As we can see here, this is rear portion of the delt, side and front. And what I actually worked with Marcelo, which you guys are going to see by the 2005 Nationals, we are focusing more on the side and rear delt that we need to develop to catch his overpowering front delt. So next exercise we're going to do is side delt, but I hope you get everything for front delt that we need to explain. So let's go and do it. After overhead presses is primary exercises for front delt, I'm going to show you primary exercises for side and rear delt. It's a lateral raises. It can be done with the dumbbells, cables, or a machine. Laterally, we can raise the arm, and if you do this in a standing position, it will stimulate side deltoid. If you bend over and do the lateral raises, we're going to stimulate rear deltoid. But I'm going to show you little tricks that I think is going to make sense to you after I show you. Most of the people do the side lateral raise without really being too concerned which portion of the deltoid is working. Most of the people do it like this. They just raise the arm laterally because they see in a magazine, they see in the gyms, everybody does it. But look at the front deltoid in this case. If Marcelo or anybody would not rotate and put the elbow up, he would really not hit the side deltoid properly. So when you do the side laterals, please make sure that your elbows are up, which will stimulate side deltoid. If you can focus right here, look, this is front, this is side delt. My little tricks in a side deltoid lateral raises is angles. We just did a front lateral raises, which stimulates the front deltoid. Extreme side is side deltoid in general. What happens in between? Well, muscle fibers always fire up regardless how we do it, but which is going to be a really primary mover depending on the angle. So if he does it like this, it's really completely side delt. However, if he starts bending over a little bit, he's going to start including a rear portion of a side delt. Not rear deltoid, I'm talking about the rear portion of a side delt by actually bending forward. If he leans backwards the opposite way, actually he's going to work a front portion of a side delt. So also not moving in the front completely and not moving on the side, but somewhere in between would hit the front fibers of the side deltoid. So let's demonstrate this. Okay. Correct way to do it is exactly this. Elbows up and that's it. In a seated position, he's not using momentum, so it's more isolating, it's harder to do, and I like to do it if I'm really focusing just on isolation of a side delt. If I really want to put the size, I would use heavier weights, I would allow my clients to maybe use a little bit momentum to remove the dumbbells up. Okay, go ahead, a few more. All right, now stand up. So the same, exact same exercise but doing in the standing position. Harder to do the way he does it right now without using momentum, dumbbells on the side of the body. Or if he wants to use a power move, he can put the dumbbells in front and use that little momentum and much heavier weight, as we were talking about, fast twitch muscle fibers to stimulate the growth. Okay, let's do the cables. In a cable exercises, the only difference is that you're not going just against the gravity, like in dumbbell side laterals. Here we are going against low pulley and a weight that's going to be pulled all the way. Go ahead. So the range of motion is somewhat longer. As you can see, it can be stretched. And my trick here is I like to do cables to create deeper separation. If you really look, he stretches deltoid more than he would do in just dumbbell laterals. Okay. Now do the behind the neck, behind the neck. Okay. You see in magazines and a lot of training videos, a lot of top professionals do this exercise. Behind, back, side laterals, as this really isolates deltoid and excludes the front delt somewhat. Okay, that's good. Tricks that I was showing you in the chest training. Decline presses, working a lower chest, flat, working a middle, incline, working upper. What happens if you go all the way up? Military presses we just did, it's for deltoid. So how we move the arm, different portion of the muscle is working. In the lateral raises, I'm gonna show you from the side. If I do the bend over position, is a rear deltoid. And now if I'm standing up, all the way to the standing position, this is a side, and anything in between would be rear portion of the side delt. So those are the little tricks that I would like you to try in your training next time you do the delts. Try those variations, a little bit different angles. I promise you're gonna feel completely different stimulation. And finally, my favorite exercise for side delt, again, would be triple drops on the side lateral. It's very intense. You would choose the heaviest weight possible that you can do for maybe 5 to 10 repetitions. As soon as you finish this, you would go to the drop set, the lighter, and you know, finally, third drop. Triple drops are able to hit fast twitch and slow twitch muscle fibers in the same set. It's very intense and very effective. So let's move on to the next shoulder exercise. We're back in the shoulder training routine after overhead presses for front deltoid, side laterals for side deltoid. We are moving on to the rear deltoid. So Marcel is gonna demonstrate first version of my rear deltoid lateral raise program, which is in seated position. Leaning as much forward as he can, he would just raise his arm laterally, driving the elbows up. As you can see, rear delts are involved majorly, but as he is still seated, in seated position, some of the rear portion of the side delts are being involved as well. Stand up. If he stands up and doing this position, it's more extreme angle, so rear deltoids are isolated more than in a previous position. It's possibly good choice for a heavy duty compound dumbbell move. He can use a very heavy weight using this exercise for a fast twitch fiber for a growth. Thank you. Instead of bilaterally, he can do this with one arm at a time. And here is the choice that I like to use. Holding the bench, using a one arm at a time, powering up and controlling on the way down. With the dumbbells, great choice, or with the cables. Use the cable version. You know, doing cables, he's again able to stretch his deltoids much more. You can see in this position right now, all the way down, yes, which creates a little bit more separation, and it's a great choice for a rear lateral raises. We can use the incline bench when I like to isolate my rear deltoids and not use the very heavy compound moves. Do the cables. Yeah. It can be done with the cables. Incline bench helps for a physiological position. There's no pressure on his lower back like this. So he can focus only on the rear delts. And as you can see, stretching all the way with a low pulley cable would not be able to be accomplished with the dumbbells, as gravity would just go straight down, okay? And use the dumbbells, both dumbbells. This is, for me, favorite finishing move, where you can just use a lighter weight, but a squeeze on the top, and pretty much do rear delts, as you can see, majorly involved in this exercise. Good, done. And I have an additional exercise that I like to do for rear delts, which actually hits all three heads of the deltoid muscle. It's one of Arnold Schwarzenegger's favorite exercises. Using a low pulley, it will be done like this with the straight arm. Yes, straight arm, okay. Good, thank you. So to recap everything we did for our shoulders, any kind of overhead presses, barbell behind the neck in front, dumbbells, machines, overhead press, right. Moving on into the side laterals for a side deltoid, focusing on the different aspects. If you do any angled move, would hit different fibers of the side deltoid. It can be front, middle portion of a rear portion of a side delt. And finally, rear deltoids, which is done everything in a bend over position to stimulate rear portion of a delt. What is really most important to know is heavy weights, repetition protocols between 6 and 12 repetitions would give you a size. If you do more than that, 12, 15 repetitions or something more, also stimulates slow twitch muscle fibers, which would give you endurance, muscle tone, definition, and so on. I like to use one fast twitch and one slow twitch fiber move for front, for a side, and for rear delt. I gave you many options so you can choose whichever exercise you want to use for a heavy compound, fast switch stimulation move, or one for a shaping. And finally, rear portion of a delt, it's important to say if you move the elbows closer to the body, we're going to involve the latissimus too much, which would really take, you know, from a shoulder stimulation. So I would only tell you in that particular bend over position, make sure that elbows are not coming close to the body, as you would exclude the rear delt somewhat. So that would be rear deltoid portion of a shoulder training. And we are here at the final segment of a shoulder training routine. We did a front, middle, and a rear portion of a deltoid. And now I'm going to show you upright rows, very common bodybuilding exercise. It can be done many different ways, using a dumbbells, barbell, or a cables. Marcel is going to demonstrate. This particular exercise does trapezius as well. So it connects to the deltoid. Trapezius is muscle right here, and it's used tremendously during this upright rowing movement. But the whole shoulder girdle is going to work in this one, the front, in the middle, and the rear portion of the delt. And I turn around so you can see, yeah, just like that, go up. So as you can see, go ahead. Trapezius is very much involved, rear deltoid, side deltoid, as well as front. Different angles, he can do very wide, go wide, okay. Elbows up, yeah, good. All the way close, turn around, yeah. Front, side, rear deltoid, trapezius, rhomboids, everything on the back, and do it with the dumbbells. Or dumbbell upright rows, not so common, but very good exercise, driving the elbows up. Okay. And a cable version. Straight up, good. If you can see, a lot of small little muscles involved, contributing to the upright rowing movement, helping the deltoids finishing this move. So that will be it for our training segment for our shoulders. I hope that now you have all the tools to build Olympia-sized deltoids, and I'll see you next time in the next episode of a Fit Show powered by bodybuilding.com. Thank you.